Hi, it's Paul. Today I want to talk about seal-in logic. And to demonstrate it, I'm going to use my tank and factory I.O. and a little tiny ladder logic program that I've written. So here's my factory I.O. and I'm in run mode. And here's my tank. I'll put that in play mode. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this run. Now the intent here is I've got a low level switch and I've got a high level switch. I want this tank to fill up until it hits the high level switch. I'm going to use my low level switch to turn on the fill valve or to open the fill valve. And so what I got is I've got an input from my low level valve. It's an examine if closed. Sorry, examine if open. And that's sending a signal to my fill valve. So when the water's below the low level sensor, it should open that fill valve and fill the tank up. And let's see how that works. So I'm going to remove this force and the tank's going to start filling. And we'll see here we got our low level. And now we're going to get our low level, but I've got a problem. As soon as it hits low level, as soon as it gets above low level, it stops filling. And I want it to fill all the way up to the high level so I can have a full tank. I'm going to put in a seal in so that when the fill valve opens, it can keep itself open and stay open until I hit the high level. I'll go offline here. And I want to put in a branch. And in that branch, I'm going to use this fill valve to seal itself on. And I need to be able to break that seal. So I'm going to use the high level. And that should break that seal. Let's go back online and see how it works. And every time you download a new version from Studio 5000 to your controller, you have to refresh factory I.O. Notice I've got all bad sensors here. So I'm going to disconnect, wait for that download. Okay, that took about a minute and a half to download, so I'm going to chop the film there a little bit. Now, I've downloaded it. I need to reconnect factory I.O. And I'll go back into run mode. Now the tank's going to start filling. See, I've got low level hot, and even when it goes cold, the fill valve's going to keep filling because it's sealed itself in. And then I'm going to break that seal with a high level switch. So when this guy goes cold, the seal is going to break and the fill will stop. There we are. I hit the high level, it broke that seal, and the fill valve shut. Now, I'm going to manually open that discharge valve. And I came down a part way. I'm below the high level. See, the high level's hot here. But it's not starting that fill valve because I need to get all the way down to the low level sensor to start this seal in again before it'll seal itself in. So I'm just gonna drain this guy down till I get the low level sensor, and then we'll watch it go again. Now, once I get this all programmed, I'm going to use another seal in for the drain valve so that the low level stops the drain when it makes. So kind of the same, only opposite of what I've got here. Okay, and now the cycle starts again and it's going to fill itself up. That's how seal in logic works. You activate something and you use that thing that you've activated, in this case it's a fill valve, to seal itself on, and then you use something different to break that seal and the fill stops. Okay, that's how seal in logic works. Thanks.